Thank you, Chair, and I want to congratulate yourself and Seanan Fáil this morning on the presentation that was that we received from Prime Minister Zelensky, and we do stand with Ukraine. The HSE is once again in the public eye as a result of plans to return greater decision-making abilities to regional-based authorities rather than top-level managers. Head Minister Stephen Donnelly's plan is to set up 6 regional health authorities. If this sounds familiar, it might be, because we had regional health authorities 17 years ago. These were done away with and replaced by the HSE as per the design of the then Minister for Health and Children, Micheál Martin. I hope that in another 17 years, centralisation is not tabled as a brand new solution to the systemic issue of bloat and bureaucracy which plague our health system. But more light needs to be shone on the HIC than perhaps the department is willing to shed. Monday saw coverage of an unreleased 2019 report which showed unsafe and unacceptable treatment in emergency care departments of 9 separate HSE hospitals. 50% or more of patients spent at least one night in the emergency department on a trolley before getting a bed or being discharged. In at least one hospital, they found patients spending up to 10 nights on trolleys. The report entitled Independent Review of Unscheduled Care Performance was led by Professor Frank Keane, the former president of the Royal College of Surgeons Ireland, and addressed issues of overcrowding, saying that the dignity, privacy and safety of patients on trolleys need attention. Perhaps more worrying are the findings regarding leadership, staff and the communication between them, as well as pervasive negative work practices. Hospital staff did not always know who was in charge. The adequacy of executive leadership and operational grip gave rise to concern, and out-of-hours executive leadership commonly relied on tight rotas, often on a goodwill basis, which could promote burnout and become unsustainable. Wards containing patients with a range of illnesses, meaning consultants and nurses were constantly moving around and building to find their patients. The policy is any bed, any time, anywhere, included mixed gender wards. And taken altogether, it paints a stark picture of a healthcare service which is consistently falling far below the standard expected of it, and whose senior management lack any appetite for meaningful reform. I understand that Minister Donnelly has had enough on his plate during the COVID pandemic, but now is the time to be proactive rather than reactive and create lasting change, and I hope that we do not stop short of seeing it through.
Thank you. Sharon Keogan spoke about the HSE being in the public eye. Personally, I think it's a really good thing that the six regional authorities have been set up. Basically, this is the implementation of Sláinte Care, which was an all-party committee report. And I think that, you know, its main focus is going to be on primary care and coordination of services. And that is absolutely very much to be welcomed.